In this situation, we have water leaking out of an inverted conical tank at a rate of 10,000 cubic centimeters per minute at the same time that water is being pumped into the tank at a constant rate. So we have our 10,000, that's going to be the rate that it's going out. The tank has a height of 10 meters and the diameter at the top is 2 meters. If the water level is rising at a rate of 20 centimeters per minute when the height of the water is 3 meters, find the rate at which water is being pumped into the tank. So, one way of thinking about this, well, first off, is we want to look at the change in the volume with respect to time. Well, that's going to be the water coming in minus the water going out. And one of these we do already know. We know that the water's going out at 10,000 cubic centimeters. We want to know, this is the one we're looking for. How fast is water being pumped in? So basically what we need to do is find our dV/dt and then add the water out to get the rate that the water is being pumped in. So to set this up, we're going to first look at our inverted cone. And we know, now something to be careful of. Notice the units, cubic centimeters to meters. Let's do this whole problem in centimeters. So this I'm just going to write in a 200 cm there. And this I'm going to write in 1000 cm to remind myself to keep everything in the same units. Now I know the height of the cone is 1000 centimeters. And the diameter's 200, so let's just use the radius of 100. Because when we go to use the volume, look at the volume of the water, we'll probably just use the radius. Now in here, let's pretend like the water is at this height here. And now I want to label some variables because the level of the water is changing. So the height of the water I'll call H. The radius of the water I'll call R. So then the volume of the water is 1/3 pi r squared h, or if you like pi over 3 r squared h, that's perfectly fine. Right now we got two variables in there, so we'd like to find a relationship between them. Well, as you'll see in a lot of these cone problems, we have similar triangles because we have a triangle here inside a larger triangle. And in fact, we'll split it in half because then we can just relate the radius of each of them and the height of each of them. So the radius of our small cone is to the height of our small cone as 100 is to 1,000. So we get that this equals 0.1. This is something I can solve for R. R equals 0.1H. And now this can be plugged in for my R here to get that in terms of a single variable. So let's go ahead and do that, and I will write the pi over the 3 just to have less writing. Now something that gets missed a lot on this. This is whole 0.1H is going in for R, so that all needs to be squared. That's a very common mistake on this, on these kind of problems. And so we're going to have the 0.1 squared, which is 1/100th, so 0.01 times the pi over 3, and then I have an h squared times an h, which is, gives me an h cubed. I've got my relationship between v and h. Now I can find my related rates. So dv dt, the derivative of v with respect to time, is equal to, now I'm going to do the derivative here, 0.01 times pi over 3, and now we'll do the derivative of h. So 3h squared times dh dt. If we want to clean this up a little bit, we can certainly cancel those threes, and we get 0.01 h squared dh dt. Now we just need the rest of our measurements. So we're doing this when the height of the water is 3 meters, and just like we converted before, that's 300 centimeters. Whoops. And we also know that the water level is rising at 20 centimeters per minute. So this 300 here is our h, this 20 is our dh dt. So there's our h, our dh dt. We now have enough to solve for dv. So dv dt equals 0.01 times our h squared, so times 300 squared, times our dh dt, which is 20. That gives us the change in volume with respect to change in time. Now, to finish answering this question, remember, it wanted to know rate, it was water being pumped in. This is just the change in volume. Well, the water in minus the water out gives us the change in volume. So now we're going to take our answer for dv dt. We're going to add the 10,000, and then we'll have the rate that water is being pumped into the tank. So take your value here, add the 10,000, and you've got the rate that water is being pumped in cubic centimeters per minute.